I think the factors which you know, of course, will affect everything are the big macro factors such as GDP growth, whether any geopolitical risks, and the general interest rate environment. Suffice to say, we UBS as a house view believe that things will be generally benign. We think, you know, China will slow down somewhat, but still at a very respectable rate of more than 7%. And the US interest rate environment is still going to be at the earliest sometime in the middle of next year.
我諗首先我唔覺得話呢個會影響香港嘅金融市場地位。 因為始終香港過去20年嘅發展咧，已經係有好龐大嘅公司喺呢度上市，投資者嘅基礎、分析員，呢啲一環接一環嘅呢啲配套咧，係冇一個其他市場係可以喺相當一段長嘅時間入邊咧，係可以取代嘅。咁所以咧，我覺得呢啲短暫嘅一啲嘅聲音啊，或者係啲動作咧，係唔會影響呢啲咁樣。 咁根深蒂固嘅優勢，咁暫時嚟講咧，我哋睇到當然好多嘅注意力會係喺啲 AH 兩邊上市嘅公司。我諗隨住呢個雙邊嘅呢啲資金流咧，的確嗰個 AH 嘅價差咧就可能會相對會縮小，但我覺得咧就唔應該會係完全消失嘅，因為始終咧雙方兩邊嘅投資者嘅基礎咧都唔係好一樣嘅。 咁所以咧，有啲公司咧，可能中國嘅投資者會比較睇好嘅，咁自然 A 股會高啲。咁有啲咧倒翻轉頭咧，可能係國際投資者睇好啲嘅，咁可能 H 股會高啲。咁呢個價差咧，我諗點都會存在嘅，唔會話完全消失曬。咁你話下半年咧，我哋其實
house view 亦都覺得息率會平穩。咁我哋覺得短息咧，將會喺2015年喺第二季同第三季之間咧，先會有機會上升。